Well, as many of you may remember last year with 2015 Topps Tribute, Topps had to do a major recall on that because of some smudged autograph, and they've fixed that with some improved technology. So this year's 2016 Topps Tribute Baseball is going to deliver three autograph cards, three relic cards, and a base parallel card in every box. What's better is all autographs in this product are signed on card. Yep.
Ooh.
On card. This new technology I'm referring to, Chromax. Chromax. So look for that. Find super refractor parallels, tandem book cards, and more. But again, eight boxes per case, six packs per box, five cards per pack with three autos, three relics, and a base parallel card, including, I mean, some additional content that came notified late after release. Kenta Maeda is going to be in here and Raul Mondesi Jr. So that's pretty cool.
That is pretty cool. Plus
Yeah.
Chromax.
Yeah,
That's going to
I'm
be so much
curious.
fun to actually see.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Other things that are in tribute this year, milestone relic cards from historic MLB events, such as Clayton Kershaw's 100th win, Chris Bryant's first home run game. That'll be a card that I'm sure Ivan will be chasing down. David Ortiz's 500th home run game. Someone else that I have to find a single signed ball for to add to the 500 home run collection. And Carlos Correa's MLB debut game. I love the idea of relic
Wow.
cards tied to specific events, especially historic MLB events.
Oh, ditto that. And you know what?
Absolutely.
This is kind of cool. I don't want to cut you off
Sure.
in the roll because there's so much good stuff to talk about here. But hey, Tops, we just roasted you, but this is awesome. Because with Tops now, it's taken a little bit, it's added some urgency to the hobby and some immediacy to the hobby, but you don't get those types of things always. There have been a few autographs inserted randomly, but this is cool because it kind of mirrors that, but in a hobby product, something that we can go out and get, we can go with our kids or our
Absolutely.
friends and we can chase. Very, very cool. And we kind of talked about this and saw it coming last year when we saw the was that in Strata where they first put the holograms on that said, this is from this game. Even if it's not a significant game, you could at least see that.
Absolutely. And what's even better is you and I had a conversation about hoping that eventually that technology and authentication program eventually bridges over to other products. Guess what? It's in this one with stamp of approval, jumbo size relics of the game's biggest stars, MLB authenticated and numbered, just like those cards in Strata. So that's awesome. Also new this year, which I absolutely love, how great is it that we still have Frank Robinson and Sandy Koufax alive to celebrate the 50th anniversary of their respective Triple Crown wins? So there's a special tribute set to that, and those cards are numbered and also parallels in red of five and black numbered 101. So some really, really sweet additions to a product that was beloved ever since it's been out, ran into some problems last year, and instead of, saying we're going back and doing the same old, they went back to the drawing board and said, okay, we're gonna mix up the technology, we're incorporate, MLB authentication, we're gonna put relics in here that actually mean something, we're gonna celebrate historic events, and we're gonna make sure all the autographs are on card. Boom.
Yeah. And you know what? Even to go off of that, I was prepared because I knew it was coming off of the buybacks roast, which also, again, to be fair, Stadium Club looks amazing this year as it does.
Oh,
Just that
absolutely.
buybacks is so irritating. But I was prepared to say, look, we just Stadium Club last week, Inception this week, Tribute Net, like, come on, guys, I'm just confused. I don't even know what sets this product apart. But how cool that they tell us not just like, oh, here's some insert sets. It's like, no, you're chasing a Frank Robinson, Sandy Koufax special item. You're chasing Carlos Correa special item. That we're getting that detailed of a checklist when it comes to this. And it really makes the name Tribute mean something.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I've been a big fan of this product since it debuted way back in, I want to say, like 2002, 2001, 2003, somewhere in there, right when I was getting, hardcore back into collecting. And it's gone through many iterations, and I'm real curious to get a hands-on look at this because I think it could be one of the best. And that's my, voice of the collector opinion. Also coming out next week, a couple of great products from Upper Deck. Which one do you want to talk about, Ivan?
You caught me the one time I went on Twitter, this whole show. I would love to talk about a couple of great products. Oh, well, I'm a GC fan, so you want to take that first one, and then I'll jump into GC?
I'll take Champs Hockey. Champs Hockey is one of the most eclectic hockey sets out there, and it features a diverse mix of products, or of content, rather. The configuration for this product, 20 boxes a case, 20 packs, 6 cards per pack. You're going to find one autograph signed on card for sure, 2 relics, 4 high series cards, 9 parallels or variants, and 6 premium inserts in every box. It features a 315 card base set when you include the SPs and the high series cards. So here we are late in the season with a set building product for people who don't mind a little bit of an SP chase. Look for things in this product like mini autos inserted 1 in 288 packs, Conn Smythe trophy autographs numbered to 25, your regular card autographs 1 in 58, SPs 1 in 87, and high series 1 in 285. So some really, really good chase. Joe should be showing you on the screen right now the product breakdown. One of the nice things about Upper Deck, Ivan has mentioned it before, they lay out the pack odds almost all the time when it comes to their hockey solicitations. And This is going to show you what the relic cards are offered at, from the Canadiana odd relics, the frame mini tobaccos, all sorts of stuff. Natural wonders in the premium insert cards, famous food, fish, number one picks. Like I said, eclectic, eclectic, eclectic. Hey, maybe the fish aren't for you, but I guarantee you there's an awful lot of people who fish in this country who are also collectors. So you'd be surprised. And those are going to drop 1 in 10 packs. So if you're a fisherman and a Canadian and a hockey fan, this is definitely right up your alley.
Real quick, I do want to mention, if you are tuning in now and you wanted to get in on the Justice League giveaway, if you already have, I just did the tally on names so far, but type your name in the chat room if you want to get in on that giveaway. If you have not already, don't do it twice, because that's just painful for me. And I have to go tell you about some more hobby products and keep bringing this hobby talk. So don't be mean to me. Okay, so coming up next, kind of a derivative in some ways of what you were saying with the unique charm of Champs, is Upper Deck Goodwin Champions.
Love it.
Now, this one goes across sports and across events, historic. It's actually based on one of the oldest tobacco cards that used to exist, that back then it wasn't just baseball players. It was Houdini and random people like that. Don't quote me on that. If Houdini didn't have a card, I'm sure people know and someone will roast me in the chat room. So 2016 Upper Deck Goodwin Champions delivers 3 hits per box, including, in addition to that, 6 Goodwin Champions minis, 5 black and white high series SPs. So this is always a fun product because there are SP chases in it as well. And 5 Gaudi inserts in every box. And Upper Deck, I got to read this sentence exactly as they wrote it. Loaded with eclectic content to deliver a truly unique and rewarding break experience. Was that from their sell sheet or was that from you, actually? That might have been a Rob.
Yeah, that was a Rob.
I love it. And Rob doesn't even make himself take. He's just like, I'll let it slide that Ivan's wrong. So when we talk about 3 hits, though, what are we talking about? Well, those can come from any of the following. And I apologize for the dog in the background. We all love him. Hard signed autographs, which I imagine is a way of saying on card autographs.
That's Upper Deck's way. If you see, if you notice in every one of their solicitations, they don't use on card. They say hard signed.
Okay, so that is what that means, because I've gotten a sticker in Goodwin before, I think. But yeah, so we have hard signed autographs, single or dual swatch memorabilia cards, which if you're watching the video, one of those comes from Pearl Harbor. Wow. And that gets into what's really cool here. But we'll keep going. Origin of Species patch cards, which these are generally dinosaur related and amazing and one of the most fun chases in the product.
This is part three of the final part three of a three-part series that's been a continuity program of theirs. And this is, if you've been collecting that, this is the last part of that set. Ooh.
Wow. Is that just this year or is that counting the ones from previous years?
Counting the ones from two previous years.
Okay. Because I know I was able to hit one last year or 2 years ago and it was just such a cool card. Alice's Adventures in Wonderland Masterpieces Booklets. And I saw Upper Deck tweeted one of these a few days ago and it's just a really unique, really, really cool thing. So we've got museum relics, which the theme this year is World War II. So that gets back to that Pearl Harbor dual memorabilia card. The Supernaturals lenticular cards.
Love lenticular.
Just going to let that hang. There's a lenticular insert in this product. I'm totally buying a box of this at the National, by the way. You guys can hold me to that, and I will break it live on camera and hope and pray for a lenticular card because that's my favorite technology of all time. Even better than the Dell computer chip. Goodwin Champions Cut Signatures and then Historical Rhetoric Audio Booklets. Yeah, can't even imagine.
A couple things I want to point out right here that I have to talk about.
Go for it.
The Museum Relics of World War II. Check out some of the gallery images. They have acquired some beautiful medals and other relics and incorporated these into just dynamic book cards. I am a big World War II history buff. And a few years ago, a handful of years ago now, our producer could probably tell me, they did cards with sand from Omaha Beach in them. And I went on secondary market and paid whatever I had to get one of those because I thought it was the coolest thing. And I remember talking to Chris Carlin on Cardboard Connection Radio back then, and you know, he explained the process of how they went about acquiring the sand and whatnot. These cards take that concept to just a whole new level. I mean, they are like little mini historical masterpieces. And then you get the Historical Rhetoric audio booklets where there's actually, you know, famous speeches that are being like, you know, talk to you there as you open the card. I'm a big fan of both of those. I think that's just a really, really dynamic idea, and I will probably be picking up some good one as well. Back to you, Ivan. That's my 2 cents.
Oh, well, I mean, that's my 2 cents too. I've always had fun with this product. It's you know, there's another product that comes out usually around the same time, but you know, there's just something really fun about Goodwin. And I also, can I tell a funny story? I know that tonight's a bit shorter of a show, even though it seems to be we're at over an hour already.
Does it have something to do with the product?
It has to do with Goodwin Champions, and it has to do with the National, and it has to do with Rob's hitting of loaded product because manufacturers give loaded product to people to open.
All right, I'll allow.
Okay, so my very first National ever, 2 years ago, Upper Deck brought me there. You know, they at least facilitated me getting in. I had to pay my own plane ticket and hotel. But they, you know, did an episode of my show with me, and we had some fun. But as a thank you, actually as an apology, because the first day they were so busy, Chris Carlin reached in, he grabbed a box. He said, oh, here's a box for you then. Like, you can do this since we aren't able to shoot today. And he gave me a box of Goodwin Champions. Right when the place first opened, 5:30 on Wednesday. So then they started doing their big giveaway. So I set it down on a table right behind me and I started watching the giveaway. And part of the giveaway was they had all these balloons and people had to pop them. So I started popping balloons and I was brand new to the National, my first time ever. I turn around and I see this woman stuffing a box of Goodwin Champions into her husband's backpack and looking around like this. And I'm like, that's my box. I am getting robbed right now at the National. I've been here 30 minutes and I am getting robbed. So I go up and I'm like, hey, what are you doing? And they're like, oh, we just won this in the giveaway. And I'm like, but I didn't want to be that guy that's, you know, like making a big deal. And I was still relatively new to like doing stuff in the hobby. And I didn't want to have a fight at the National with this person. I was like, okay, whatever. I'm just going to bite the cost and I'll go buy my own box because I kind of have to open this on camera for Upper Deck since They gave it to me.
Jeez.
So I was, and then they like scurried off, and I was just like, wow, it's pretty much like that story. And I don't want to talk about, you know, blame them for their physicality, but they looked like the old, like, oh, they were just that stereotype. It was so horrible. So I go to another booth and I buy a box of Goodwin Champions from a guy for 55, 60 bucks, whatever. And I wait to open it until the episode comes out. So it was like December. I finally open this box and I hit a one of one art card, which is something I don't know if they're not in the product. I didn't quite see them on the sell sheet. Maybe they replaced it with the Alice, but back then they would hire artists, the commission artists really is the word for this, to replicate an amazing classic piece of art on a sports card, a 4x6, 3x2.5.
They're in here this year. That's the Supernaturals.
Oh, the Supernaturals. Okay. So yeah. I hit one of those and everybody thought that like Upper Deck sent me a loaded box to open. And it's like, no, the loaded box got stolen. And if it hadn't gotten stolen, who knows what I would have hit. But the one of one that I hit was from a box that I bought from a vendor who was a small store in Kentucky that had a booth set up there. And, it was just, so I just thought that was a hilarious story, but also like one of the coolest cards I've ever hit came from Goodwin Champions. Hitting those art cards is just absolutely amazing.
That's funny, but there's more in here than just history too. We should not fail to mention that you're also going to find autographs of guys like Tiger Woods, Michael Jordan, you know, all your big Upper Deck guys. But
Holly Holm,
want to know. Yeah, Holly Holm.
You've
thank
been
you
dying
for reminding
for
me. Yeah. For whatever reason, obviously she's too expensive to get into Topps UFC products or whatever. And maybe it's good that, you know, her championship was such short lived. Maybe Topps made the right decision in not paying her what she wanted. But if you've been dying for a certified Holly Holm autograph from UFC, she's in here. So very cool stuff.
Yeah.
Very cool stuff. Next up on the list, we've got a memorabilia product from Super Break in the form of frozen heirlooms. This is their first foray into hockey. And you're going to find three premium hits in every box. And this product spans a history of 80 years of hockey, loaded with premium content. And you're going to find some of the greatest players of all time. What they've done to provide some added value is every box is going to include a PSA grading coupon for 5 cards for $50.
Ooh.
Which is a savings of $75.
Wow.
So yeah,
that's
pretty
cool.
I mean, right off the bat, you know, you're offsetting your box cost there. Some of the things you should be looking for: autograph cards of semi-stars, stars, fan favorites, rookie and Hall of Famers, autograph bike back cards, which have all been authenticated by major third-party authentication companies, the patented The Bar 101 cut signature original cards, super surprises falling multiple times per case. These will replace a standard buyback autograph. Look for certified autographed jerseys, photos, magazines, pucks,
wow.
photo cuts, team sign pieces, and more. Find players that competed for the Stanley Cups, top scorers and goaltenders dating back all the way to the 1930s. Redemption coupons will be placed inside the boxes for premium memorabilia items. They're all in stock. There is no waiting. All you do is take that, send it to them, and they're going to ship it to you free.
That's awesome.
So there's no waiting around on that.
Only redemptions for things that are already in hand.
Yep. Don't you love that?
Great. So, yeah, and that makes sense too, because you're like, otherwise, again, box searching. This box has a pound of gold in it. I'm going to open this one because it's heavier than everything else. So helps prevent that. But they do a fun job, and I'm really hoping that we can get them maybe even on the show before the National, because I'd love to talk a bit about their process. Ooh, you know what's next, though?
Something we already talked about, so we can gloss over it pretty quickly. Onyx Clubhouse Collection, I think we talked about.
Oh,
that.
Yeah. I got my links backwards. I was looking at the next one.
Ad nauseum.
But it comes out this week,
and
so look for it.
It does Friday the 15th. And again, check out the checklist. One of the great things about their memorabilia products is they put, you know, the checklist of who's going to be in here. and right there on the sell sheet. So check that out on the blog, gocheapts.net. And then the last non-toy product.
Oh, I love it, though.
It's time for some football.
Well, it's a timely product, too, because...
Absolutely.
One, it's football, but two, we all saw that great video last week of a kid opening a sticker pack and hitting Chris Bryant and going crazy. Well, 2016 Panini NFL sticker and album collection comes out this week. So if you need an excuse to go to the shop and you have children, say, hey, honey, we're going to get the kids some NFL stickers. And then you can go get the other stuff and film your kids opening. And who knows, you could become internet famous and be on ESPN. And maybe, you know, Ezekiel Elliott will tweet you if you hit his card and your kid goes crazy. But yeah, so lots of fun here. Pretty standard. The stickers, $1 a pack, 7 stickers per pack. Sticker and album combo, $2, but lots and lots of fun.
Big set this year, 485 stickers, including 131 special
metalized.
Thank you, foil stickers, and a 72-page collector album. You're going to find highlights of a spread of the Super Bowl, Super Bowl winning teams, highlights of all the Super Bowls. It's jam-packed.
You'll notice that, and you know, Tracy Hackler, who does a lot of the NFL stuff for Panini, he's a huge Broncos fan. It looks like it's Broncos themed colors if you look at the picture.
I know,
milking it for
too.
All he can.
Absolutely. And then last but not least, featured figures hot in the shop next week. On the blog Monday, look for more information if you are a trading card gamer. There's be some information about several products coming out if that's of interest to you. But did want to point out, after talking about Bleacher Creature last week, that the first round of Suicide Squad plushes is coming out from Bleacher Creature. You've got Deadshot, Harley Quinn, Katana, and the Joker. And those all debut in stores also Friday the 15th. And that is going to do it for Hot in the Shop.